Greetings everyone! In this tutorial, we'll be creating a wet shader that you can use on a plane, road, stone, or anything else that's suitable for your project. Let's first create a 3D object and resize it. I have some textures here that you can get from a free website or the video description. Be sure to use HDRP or URP or download the shader graph package and then create a lit shader graph. After that, right-click on shader and choose the material option and drag it to the plane or whatever object you have. Open the floor shader. If you know or have experience with sample texture and tilling offset nodes, it's going to be so easy for you. Otherwise, don't worry, just follow me, I will explain every detail. So, we need to make some properties to can have access from the inspector. The three of them are texture 2D. The first one is the main texture, and the second is the normal map of the main texture, and the third one is for the petals texture. Let's add two more properties of vector 2 to change the size and offset of the textures. Connect the diffuse to the sample texture. There will be times when you want to manipulate the UVs, tilling or offset of your textures, normals, or results of a gradient. This is when the tilling and offset node becomes useful. Now connect the main tilling to the tilling. We repeat this process for the normal map and petals. Care when you want to use a sample texture as the normal map, you should change the type of it to the normal map. Here, we did a little trick to smooth the puddle's tiling by connecting the output to another tiling and offset. Add a blend node. The base is the main texture, and the blend one is puddles, but we don't want the alpha of the puddle's texture, so let's invert it and then connect it. Then change the opacity to a number less than 0.5 and change the mode to multiply. That's all for the base color. I have better results when I connect the puddle's texture to the smoothness, so why not? Then, let's blend the ripple and normal together and use the puddle's alpha for opacity and change the mode to overwrite. Now, let's add ripple texture and tiling properties. It makes it so realistic if we add flow to the surface, so we need the two other properties as a float for it. Another sample texture for ripple. Don't forget to change the type to normal. We want our ripple to move, so we should change the offset here to the speed multiplied by the time. Do this again for flow, but connect the tiling and offset to the simple noise and make the scale of noise to a smaller number. Save this data to UV by blend node. And here, the mode should be divide or screen. I don't really know which one is best here. You can change them later. After connecting them to normal and cleaning up here, save the floor shader and switch to the floor inspector. Now it's time to place the textures and give them a random number. The petal's texture must be white and black like I have. Now, after smoothing the petals on the main texture, you can see them better. The ripple texture should be a normal map. Now, if your water is like here, go to the water texture and enable the create from grayscale and set the bumpiness to a small number. I have ready-made decals prefabs. If I put them here, it's like I created a road. Some of you may ask, can this water reflect objects? The answer is yes, with a reflection probe, or if you're using HDRP like me, by adding a screen reflection to the volume and enabling that in your HDRP asset. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like and comment.